guys, it's me, Yoko. Today, I am here to bring you guys this very exciting news, which is likely to be historical. And that is the first worldwide English book release from the Japanese political field. So what kind of book am I talking about? The book explains why South Korea continues its skewed anti-Japan campaign, and also based on the investigation of the attitude of Korea against Japan and the analysis of the latest data, the book shows how South Korea's anti-Japan policies are actually ruining Korean society and economy, and where the relationship between Japan and Korea are going. And the book is called Getting Over It, Why Korea Needs to Stop Bashing Japan. And to tell you the truth, this is a long-awaited English translation of this bestseller named Nase Hanrichi Kankoku ni Mirai wa Nai no ka. I know that it sounds pretty controversial already, and you might be wondering what's actually written inside, so I will introduce the table of contents as a sneak peek. Chapter 1, Raging Anti-Japan Storm in Park Geun-hye, South Korea. Chapter 2, How South Korea's Anti-Japan Ideology Took Form. Chapter 3, New Developments in Anti-Japan Ideology. Chapter 4, Why Can't the Anti-Japan Mentality Be Eradicated? Chapter 5, How Did Japan Rule Over Korea? Chapter 6, Dead End for South Korean Society. Chapter 7, Can Good Relations Be Restored Between Japan and South Korea? And now let me talk about the author of this book. Her name is Ms. Sungpa Oh. Since she's widely known as a leading expert of Japan and Korea relations studies, many of you might know of her, but I will give you guys a brief introduction. Ms. Sungpa Oh was born in South Korea, and now she is a professor at Takushoku University's Faculty of International Studies, and she's also a critical writer. And after she first came to Japan, she studied here, and she earned her master's degree from Tokyo University of Foreign Studies. She began her writing career while she was in university, and her book, Wind on My Skirt, became a bestseller in 1990. She has written many other books, including winner of the 5th Yamamoto Shichihei Award, Exclusionist Korea and Open Japan, To Japanese Who Dislike Japan, and How I Became a Believer in Japan. And in 1998, she became a naturalized Japanese citizen. Believe it or not, though, she's been refused to enter South Korea, which is nothing but a hideous violation of human rights that she has been forced to face. And it might be because her success in Japan has given a wrong impression, or it might be because the South Korean government imagines what she insists is against the national interests of Korea, which is not true. However, Ms. Sungpa Oh is undaunted, and she keeps speaking the truth. I have read Getting Over It myself, of course, and I can tell you that if you guys read this, you'll be amazed and impressed, because this book is not biased. It is based on objective analysis of facts and data, which lets you have the feeling of reading a mystery novel, for example, as you go forward, because it solves issues one after another with detailed information that comes from various viewpoints. By reading this book, you will get to the truth about South Korean society and the relationship between Japan and Korea, and for that, I'm hugely counting on this book, because I know that this can bring a new mutual understanding that was never there before to the international society. So please read this book. I'm very curious of what you think of what's written inside, and I'd like to share the thoughts with you. So once you are done reading this book, please share your thoughts in the comment section below. I'll be waiting. So thank you for watching. I guess I will talk to you guys later. Bye!